In this video, we're going to talk about vector and raster graphics. What's the difference between these two kinds of computer graphics? And we're also going to talk about how we can manipulate raster graphics and manipulate vector graphics, as well as taking a screenshot using the print screen key. I have opened an empty PowerPoint document, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the placeholders. I'm going to create a text box, and I'm going to put a letter in that text box, and I'm going to make that letter very large. I can only make it 96 points using the drop-down, so I'm going to type inside this box, and I'm going to make it 300 points. Now you notice that when I make this letter larger, it still looks good. It has nice smooth curves. It doesn't look at all blocky or pixelated. I'm going to take a screenshot, and I can do this by pressing the print screen key on my keyboard. When I press print screen, it copies my current screen to the Windows clipboard. And I can then paste that screen, for example, by right-clicking and clicking on paste. And notice that I have a screenshot of my screen showing PowerPoint, but I have it inside PowerPoint. I can use the positioning handles to resize my screenshot if I'd like. I can go up to the Picture Tools Format ribbon and then click on Crop, and I could crop my screenshot down. So I'm going to crop my screenshot down so that I just have the S that I took a screenshot of. And then I'm going to use the adjustment handles to increase the size of the S. Now if you look at these two S's, they look identical, but they're not. I can see this when I go to zoom in. Right now I'm at 70% magnification, and I can zoom in hitting the plus symbol. And notice that as I zoom in, the S on the right, which was my screenshot, begins to look more and more jagged, while the S on my left, which was my font, still has these nice clean curves. This is because the S on my left is a vector graphic, a vector representation. Things like fonts, certain kinds of illustrations, which means they're representations of mathematical formulas, where the unknown is the width and the height. As you can see on the right, the raster graphic has jagged edges, whereas the vector graphic has these nice smooth curves. I'm going to zoom back out, and I'm going to remove these two objects. I'm going to click on the Insert ribbon, and I'm going to click on Clipart. Now, I'm going to do a search using the word dog, and when I go to search, I'm going to continue using all collections, which means that it's going to look on my hard drive for images that are part of Microsoft Office, and it's also going to look on Microsoft Office's website. And for media types, I'm going to deselect photographs, movies, and sounds, and I only want a certain kind of Clipart file. I'm going to start with a raster Clipart file called a GIF. GIFs are commonly seen on the web for simple images or GIF animations. So I'm going to select a GIF image and I'm going to do a search on the word dog. So I find a bunch of images. When I hover my mouse over this image, there's a tooltip that appears and it says that the image is 70W by 70H pixels. That means this image is 70 pixels wide by 70 pixels tall. And notice that it also says the image is only 3 kilobytes. I'm going to drag this image onto my PowerPoint presentation. And notice what happens when I resize it. As I resize it and make the image larger, the quality of the image degrades because the image was not meant to be displayed at this resolution. If I go back and look for selected media types, and instead of selecting a GIF file, I select a Windows meta file, which I know is a vector format, and then do a search, I can find an image that, when I scale it up, still looks good. And notice that no matter how close I get to this image, the image still looks good. With a vector image, I can ungroup the vector image and manipulate the component parts. If I right-click on the image, go to the Group menu and select Ungroup, It first tells me that since I imported the picture, it's not technically a group, but I can convert it to a Microsoft Office drawing object. So I'll click on Yes. And now I can right-click on this image again, go to Group, and click on Ungroup. And it has broken the image down to a number of component shapes. If I want to manipulate these shapes, I can easily do that, such as removing the dog bone from his paw. I'm going to delete my raster image to give myself some room, and I can come over and just simply move the dog bone and all the parts of it. I can take parts of the dog and recombine them back into groups, which will make them easier to manipulate, selecting them and then clicking on group and regrouping. This will let me take other pieces of art, such as, let's say, another copy of the dog image, and I can take and make it look like he's holding onto this dog. Now, it doesn't look like he's holding onto it yet, because the new image I inserted is on top of the previous image that I altered. But since I made a group out of the paw, I can right-click on the paw, bring it to front, and it will bring it to the front of my PowerPoint presentation, making it look like the other image is behind it. I'm going to delete the objects that are on my screen and give you another example of how editing vector images can be very handy. I was interested in creating a piece of artwork. I wanted a sort of iconic fish symbol, so I did a search for fish in Clipart. I wanted a very simple shape that I could put words in, and I found this, which would suit my purposes. Once I had this piece of clip art, I could right-click on it, go to Group, Ungroup, again, ask me if I want to convert it to a Microsoft Office drawing object, and I'll click on Yes. Then I can try to ungroup it again. And now I have it as its component pieces. I can simply take the piece I want, pull it away, delete the rest. And now I have this nice little fish symbol that I can manipulate. I can go to the Drawing Tools Format ribbon. I can change the full color. I can give the shape an outline. Let's say I want to take this image and put it inside a box to symbolize a fish tank. I can go to the Insert Shapes, and I can grab the square shape, and then I can draw a box. I can take this box, and I can change the fill using a gradient, and give it the appearance of, say, a sea, or I can create a custom gradient and adjust the levels of the gradient, choosing my colors. And again, I can send this to the background, and then my fish would appear in front of it. I can make copies of my fish, have them be different sizes, have them be different colors, etc.